today is how to attend a lecture, part 1. And don't forget to see following part 2 also. I have lot many tips for you for this particular topic. These days, large amount of subject matter is available on internet, and that's why students have a very casual approach for attending the lectures. They feel that lecturers are not necessary anymore. First, realize this fact that if you feel that education can be completed by self-study, then in the classrooms of various schools and colleges, you would have found only books placed over there and not the teachers. Presence of a teacher in a classroom makes lots of difference. Your understanding of a subject matter becomes very clear. Your thinking ability increases. Your innovative ideas are boosted. You get motivated for learning positively. You are able to undergo assessments. You get ideas and directions for project preparations. And you get guidelines for going about internship and later on for the jobs. Whenever I visit various institutes, I find empty classes, large number of latecomers. Students attend only to comply with 70% attendance requirement. Students do not always carry subject related notebooks and also pens. Students come, they sit, they listen, and they do not interact with the teacher at all. And at the end of the lecture, students do not ask questions because they have not understood the subject matter at all and they have not thought about the subject matter. These are few important tips before you start attending a lecture. First, collect a copy of syllabus. Then, collect teaching schedule. Because in teaching schedule, teacher has given a complete sequence of how he or she will go about the topics. Then be sure that you have read subject matter of previous lecture and understood it very well. By chance, if you have missed previous lecture, then get details of that lecture from your classmates. Keep a separate notebook for every subject and keep your subject related notebook and pens, at least two, ready at night a day before the lecture, and attend your classroom at least 10 minutes before the scheduled time of the lecture. There is no problem in taking notes, but only taking notes and then reproducing these ditto without understanding the subject matter is not proper. That's why you will have to improve reading ability. Spend at least 2 to 3 hours every day for reading your textbook matters. And once you understand the subject very well by reading, then only you will be able to solve multiple choice type of questions. Remember that. And also you will be able to prepare various projects on the basis of the subject matter you have understood. Another skill you have to improve is your listening ability. Listening is the ability to identify and understand what others are saying. And by improving this ability, you will understand the speaker's accent or pronunciations, his grammar, his vocabulary, and grasping his meaning. and listening is a medium through which you gain large portion of education. Don't forget that. Get fast adapted to various modes of teaching of various teachers. Some use chalk and blackboard. Some use PowerPoint presentations. Some dictate only notes. Some use videos. Some only talk and interact with the students. And also some use textbooks. And get adapted to these various modes as early as possible. Students often ask, what should we do when we attend lectures? Should we take notes or only we should listen? I feel you get most of the lectures if you do both. But then remember, don't focus on getting everything down to the extent that you miss what the lecturer is saying. Remember that actively listening and thinking are very, very important. For example, for a topic like carbohydrate, chemistry of carbohydrates, you don't have to take notes for the definition and then properties and classification of carbohydrates, right? It's already given in the book. But for importance of the metabolic pathways and deranged metabolism and pathophysiology related to that, for that you require good notes. Well, at the end, I'm repeating again, be prepared before the lecture, because preparation before the lecture provides the background knowledge you need to be an effective listener and an effective student. Then know what the lecture will be about by referring to your teaching schedule and do any required pre-reading. If lecture slides of PowerPoint presentation are available before the class, download them. Review notes from previous lectures. Set up notebooks for note taking and arrive on time and sit near the front. In order to take good notes, you need to hear and also see clearly. And at the end of the lecture, teacher may ask you questions and you should be able to answer those questions. It is only possible if you have focused well on listening and understanding the subject matter. And then it is your turn to ask questions to your teacher, and that is called as your spirit of inquiry ability. Spirit of inquiry ability is developed very well only if you read and understand the subject matter well. And remember one thing, do not ask questions on basic subject matter. For example, if protein chemistry is the topic, then you are not supposed to ask questions on definition, then properties and classification of proteins and amino acids. But questions should be asked on how a normal protein molecule becomes abnormal under various pathophysiological conditions and due to genetic disorders. Do not forget to see part 2 of this presentation, and yes, kindly subscribe and share my channel Praful Godkar educational videos with all your classmates and friends. Thank you very much.